There are a plethora of mysterious creatures in the world of Teyvat. We have degraded human beings who talk like minions. We have cat people. We have goat people. We also have whatever that is kind of people. Most importantly, we have gods and demigods that live their whole life using a single word.
City of Freedom.
Wine.
Ton Winery's wine is the wine. City of the Wind, finest of wines.
Wine!
Order!
First contract.
Contract.
Eternity.
Ambition.
Ambition.
Eternity!
But we're not here to talk about mythologies of Teyvat. I mean, we kinda are, but not every mythos that this Vegas Hell game wants to show us. In this video, we'll be discussing every bit of design and aesthetic choices in making the Shogun's right-hand official of Inazuma. Yep, she's the one and only Yae Miko. No, I'm just kidding. She's the mask-wearing, bow-wielding, teleporting bird woman of Inazuma, Sara Kujou. Now starting with this video, I'm gonna be taking a bit of a different tone, as well as flow of discussing and being a bit more satire with the way I talk, because lately I've been watching my own videos and not gonna lie, they're pretty boring. I mean, who would want to sit in their chair or lie in their bed and listen to a monotone or two-tone voice robot talking about eternity of all things? Now, here's the 15 things you didn't know about Sara Kujou. At number 1, the Heavenly Dog or Heavenly Sentinels are a type of legendary creature found in Japanese folk religion. They're considered to be a type of yokai or Shinto kami/god. Now, these Tengu were originally thought of to take forms of birds and monkeys. That's right, monkeys. Now, they're traditionally depicted with human, monkey, and avian characteristics, which is birds, if you didn't know. If you watched anime related to Japanese mythology, aka every Studio Ghibli movie, you'll see at least one type of yokai in every possible scene of each of those movies. Now, Tengu in Japanese folklore is a type of mischievous supernatural being, sometimes considered the reincarnated spirit of someone who was proud and arrogant in life. The Tengu are renowned swordsmen and are said to have taught the military arts to the hero named Yoshitsune way back in the feudal era. Now, if you guys read lore, which I think you guys don't, if you do, then good on you. It's quite similar to the story of Sasayuri, one of the Shogun's generals who taught the people of Inazuma the martial arts of Tengu Jutsu. Now, if you're gonna ask me what Tengu Jutsu is, I have no idea. But they taught the people of Inazuma what that is, so hey, that's pretty good. The multiple variation of Tengu are more confusing than the entire Fate timeline and Stymesgate timeline combined, because history is even more diluted than Barbara's elemental skill. But for Genshin Impact's lore's sake and for you guys' sake, I've placed their form of Tengu as a mix of the Kou Tengu, the Dai Tengu, and the Karasu Tengu. Now think of these names as an evolution of the Tengu race as they slowly became more and more human. In what manner or how they became more human, I don't want to discuss that. I've seen enough of that to know where this is going. So the Dai Tengu or Long Nose Tengu represent a later stage in the development of the concept of Tengu in Japan, possessing the closest form to that of humans, but they have really long noses. Now the Kou Tengu and the Karasu Tengu, or in English, the Crow Tengu, characterize more bird-like features, as well as having bird-like faces than human ones, having beaks rather than mouths, more feathers, and even sounding like birds while they talk. Now the Dai Tengu or Long Nose Tengu signifies the alien or foreign, mysterious, and sometimes frightening, and superhuman power. Now judging from history and from what I'm saying, if you can piece them together, Tengu are basically the British and Americans when they first landed in Japan, way back when ships and boats were the go-to form of transportation. And because of their pointy and elongated nose, they were called Tengu by the local population of Japan. If you don't believe me, there's one example named Commodore Perry drawn as a Tengu in one of their paintings. If you look them up, there is an actual painting of the man looking like a Tengu and a signature of the artist that made it. So all you Americans and British people out there, you're basically Tengus. Now their supernatural powers include shape-shifting into human form or animal forms, just like a certain Miko that we know of who does not want to turn into a fox. Speaking to humans without moving their mouths, moving instantly from place to place without even using their wings, which is basically teleportation at that point, and the sorcery of appearing uninvited in the dreams of the living. Safe to say, Sara can go to your dreams and
in your dreams.
Yeah. Now, I have nothing to say to this other than, holy crap, we need a Sara Kujou Awakened version, where she actually uses her mask and wings, even if she's a 4-star, or if you can make her a 5-star if you want, but please, just make her use her wings and her mask. Like, come on, MiHoYo. Okay, now that we're done with the basic forms and how Tengus look like and why they're called Tengu, we can finally move on to their clothing. We all know and want to see about the Tengu are associated with the ascetic, that's right, ascetic, not aesthetic, practice of Shugendo, and are usually depicted in the garb of its followers called the Yamabushi. As such, they possess a lot of trinkets and clothing that the said Yamabushi would wear. So TLDR, the Yamabushi are monks or hermits who devote their lives to asceticism, you can say that 3 times in a row, within the mountains, avoiding worldly possessions for the pursuit of spiritual life. If you've seen or heard of people sitting on a rock under a raging waterfall for a prolonged period of time and shouting incoherently, then this is them. But don't let their frail and gentle nature fool you. The Yamabushi are actually on par with samurai. Yes, those kinds of samurai. These guys are complete badasses. They can pray for your friend's dead corpse while benching your enemy's dead corpse, at the same time reciting every verse of the Bible. In real life, Tengu masks are used or no stage plays and certain Shinto festivals. They're also often used as a decoration since the Tengu are thought to frighten bad spirits and bring good luck. And it is also worth noting that the Yamabushi do not possess such masks within their person, because they do not worship spirits that copy them to trick other people, because, well, that's heresy. But within Genshin Impact's lore, a Tengu mask is only worn specifically by the Tengu race, and the Tengu masks are used as a catalyst to store their magic and act as foci for channeling and condensing it, and possibly awakening them to reach critical levels of power. Once again, MiHoYo, please awaken Sara Kujou. Moving on to the top of their mask, this is called a Tokin, or a Tokin Crown. Now, these are traditional or fictional small red or black boxes worn on the foreheads of Yamabushi or Tengu. It is not only worn as a decoration for the head, but also used as a drinking cup. Next are the Hachinawa or Kainowau red cord, which can be found on Sara's forearms. That's right, forearms. Forearms. These are 2 cords carried specific to the size which is needed to ensure safety at the time of dangerous passages above the chasms, being called the umbilical cord of Fudo. For TLDR purposes, this is a safety rope for traveling up and down mountains. The colors range from yellow, violet, red, chestnut, or white according to the function and the rank of the user. But for Genshin's lore reasons, the cords, although short and only wrapped around Sara Kujou's arms, could be used as charms for dangerous missions or journeys. Now, the Yamabushi also wear something called a Yuigesa, which is part of what they wear along with their robes when making the ascent to the mountains. Now, I can't actually find a reason why they wear these, but I mean, they look cool, so why not? Although creative and design choices were made to scatter some parts of it on her clothing, you can find the tail of the Yuigesa on her back, which is very uncanny to that of the real Yamabushi's Yuigesa in real life. Number 10, going lower to her waist, you can see a bunch of electro sigils hanging around her waist. This is most likely a design choice related to the Hirataka Nenju or the Yamabushi's rosaries. It's the name given with a special rosary with 108 beads employed in Shogun. 108. Do you guys even have any idea how many beads those are? Now, I'm a Catholic and the beads we have is only 59. And the whole process of using it takes about an hour and a half depending on the type of prayer that we do. But come on, that's twice the amount of beads. These are often worn on the neck or wrapped on the wrist. But for Sara's case, it was placed around her waist. Oh, I'm not a rapper, but used as a counting frame, it makes it possible to count the number of mantras recited at the time of something called japa. What the hell is japa? Now, japa is a form of Japanese meditation performed either while sitting or doing various activities. The beads symbolize passions which one polishes all day through perseverance and practice. So this type of meditation they can do while walking, sitting, jumping, hitting people, or flying, whatever they do, whatever the Tengu do. Number 11, if you look at Sara's flared dress, I don't know what this is called, but it has a pattern called the Sayagata pattern. The Sayagata is a traditional repeating pattern of interlocking manji or swastika. No, not that kind of swastika, this kind of swastika, which originated in Indian architecture. Now, this kind of patterns were found in Chinese decorative art and textiles, and also in the Japanese kimonos which Sara is wearing. Now, these were used for about thousands of years ago by the ancient Buddhists, and the symbol came to Japan around the 1500s and is known to represent life and strength. Next, we'll be moving on to her hands and her legs. Now, the leggings and mittens worn by Sara Kujou are called the kyahan and teko, respectively. These are worn to protect from scratches while climbing, or in Sara's case, to protect her from senyora, which did not work. The gaiters, or the kyahans, protect from the leeches whenever they go to the very moist or rainy areas of the mountains. These leggings and mittens are also worn by their warrior friends, the samurai. Next is that thing that she swings whenever she uses her ultimate. Tengus are commonly depicted holding a magical feather fan, which you see that, of course, Sara is holding whenever you use her ultimate. But in folk tales, these fans sometimes have the ability to grow or shrink a person's nose. Okay. But usually, they have attributed to the power to stir up powerful winds, even with the most lackluster swing. Remember that scene in Naruto where Temari fights against Shikamaru and Temari has a huge fan? Yeah, like that, but it's way smaller. And if a Tengu like Sara slightly swung it at your face, it'd be like a Boeing 747 taking off right in front of you. Next are her feet. Everybody loves feet, right? Japanese Tabi, which are usually understood today to be a kind of split-toe sock that is not meant to be worn alone outdoors. Well, much like regular. However, tabi were originally a kind of leather shoe made from a single animal hide. As evidenced by historical usage and the earlier form of the word, tanbi, which means single hide. So these socks were also shoes, but they were called socks, but they were also shoes. What the heck, Japan? Finally, we move on to the one-tooth Getta sandal, often called the Tengu Getta on her shoes. Now, these type of sandals are very much associated with the strange accessories that the Tengu wear. So the one-tooth Getta sandal more often worn by the Tengu than that of a normal person. Now imagine walking on your tippy toes, but your tippy toes are on the arch of your feet. Ouch. So now that we've mentioned all of these wonderful ingredients, we add a few lines, a little bit of curves, and some really good voice acting. We get the bold, decisive, skilled leader of the Tenryou Commission, verified simp of the Electro God, mask-wearing, back-dashing, electro-zapping Bennett 2.0 of Inazuma, Sara Kujou. I have no idea where I was going with that one. And there you have it, guys. Every detail I could find about Sara Kujou's design. I was out for a week. Sorry I was out for a week or so, but I'm back and that is all that matters. So I'll be trying a new video format with a lot more energy than I used to in my next videos. And I'm pretty excited to see how it all goes. So yeah, that's gonna be it for this video. I'll see you guys later. Bye!